Praise be to Jesus. Today's gospel and reflection. The Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 13. Jesus said to them, "A prophet is respected everywhere except in his hometown and in his own family. And he did not perform many miracles there because of their lack of faith." A prophet is never welcomed in his hometown. All the four evangelists depict this event in their gospels. This can be easily understood as it occurs many times in ordinary life situations. As the proverb goes, the familiarity breeds contempt. The people of Jesus' hometown were awestruck by his wisdom and power. But they were not prepared to accept his teaching, as they found in him an ordinary person of their own locality, known to them very well. Their minds were closed to the truth. The Jews and Pharisees were self-complacent to accept the simple but great truth that Jesus is the Son of God. To see the hand of God working and experience his power, purity of heart is essential. "Blessed are the pure of hearts, for they shall see God," says Matthew 5:8. Very often, Jesus has appreciated the simple faith of the ordinary people who believed in him and in his power, like the Syrophoenician woman, the blind person, and many, those who experienced his wisdom and the healing touch for their bodies and minds. Prejudices and judgments should be vacated so that the ray of truth will enter into the darkened corners of the lives. Jesus is present in our everyday lives. He is present in the Holy Eucharist. He is alive in the Holy Scripture. Do we ever find time to listen to his voice and believe in his almighty power? Many experience the redeeming power of the Lord when they surrender lives to the Lord, to the power of God. We need to check the attitude of our faith and our hearts. The same sermon can become a living flame to some, but to others it becomes a barrier. God has his own ways of working. We should not judge persons from their outward appearances or family background. Many a message is gone futile when the minds are prejudiced. To be free from prejudice and judging nature, we need to fill our minds with positive thoughts. When the negative thoughts come to us, we need to filter it with the eyes of faith and trust in God, turning the same into good. At least seeing one goodness in the person or the situations that take place, then we will be able to overcome it so that no prophet is ever rejected in our family, in our hometown, and in our society. Amen.